A place vanished from the map, a national secret with epic spirit and a peaceful vision. This is the 816 underground nuclear base. The scene of a sci-fi blockbuster are not computer-generated special effects, but are in fact secret facilities in Chongqing, China. In the 1970s, located on the Wujiang River against the black job of the Wulin Mountain.
原子弹的主要的这个原料就是需要靠反应堆来进行一个提炼。我们86工程就是做这个反应堆的。86工程呢，它修建的这个背景主要还是国际形势，当时特定的一个环境下，需要我们有这种国之重器来支撑我们这个新中国的一个发展。66年开始新建，前后长达18年的建设时间，84年是停建。
The 816 Underground Nuclear Project is the world's largest artificial cave, reaching 79.6 meters high, equal to a 20-story building, and more than 30 meters below the Wujiang River. The total area stretches to 13,000 square meters, with several buildings within the cave. This is China's first nuclear power plant.It can produce electricity and generates enough heat from its nuclear waste to power the entire project. This is the area where after neutron collisions and energy exchange, the reactor produces three kinds of material that sink to the bottom of the core.After layering, they're transported to a processing plant, and after more than a year of cooling and denuclearization, they can become plutonium-239. And this is 101 nuclear reactor hole core. There are 2,001 small holes in a huge core disc.They act as slots for fuel rods used to generate plutonium-239, which is the main nuclear fuel used in nuclear weapons. This is an unfinished observatory. Once the nuclear reactor hole is opened, you'll be completely off limits.
我们这个101大厅反应堆大厅上面这个航车啊，至今都是一个谜，因为资料没解密，我们也查不到。到底那个航车100多吨航车怎么安装上去的？通过当时的那种技术上，我们怎么安装上去的？我想的话也是发挥了集体的智慧，克服了重重的困难，啊，这些就是摆在现实上的一个问题。
Devices such as electric meters are used to balance the current and voltage in the rods. Such a small potentiometer was equal to the price of a 14-inch color TV in the 1980s.The diversion tunnel, which is used for reactor cooling, has a diameter of 3.5 meters and a total length of 3 kilometers. If started in the dry season, it could pump approximately one-third of the Wujiang River's volume. In addition to the regular route, we were fortunate to visit closed sections.
它是个晶洞工程，因为它是整个山体挖空，挖空了以后，它那个山体还能承载得了，承载得了，就是整个山，因为它里头没有支撑的，
对，
它全是冻死没有支撑的，所以这对岩石的要求是比较高的。另外一个呢，就是对这个就是反应堆，它需要大量的水来作为一个冷却剂啊，这一块呢，就是说需要有水源，有充沛的水源，啊，乌江水源充沛，然后当时的定点就选在了这个重庆涪陵。
The completion of 816 project is difficult not only due to the rock hardness and water flow within the mountain, but it also requires tremendous manpower to overcome several hurdles.
首先就是说我们挖山洞，好，我们工程兵54师官兵，应该说是，不畏艰险，也是统一调度、统一指挥、团结协作。
对。
啊，然后在这个挖的过程中，应该来说他们这个还是。很艰难，很艰辛的，一块石头加一块肉，什么概念呢？就前后左右上下，除了背后没有，它是五面嘛，然后都是石头，遇到很多包括塌方、透水，当时的设备设施没有那么先进，当时的建设应该是克服了很多困难，同时也是发挥了大家集体的智慧。
Nevertheless, The magnificent project was suspended in 1984 due to changes in the international context and China's commitment to nuclear non-proliferation.
所以说我们86这个工程为和平而建也是为和平而停、大家当时觉得还是很遗憾花了那么大心血，它是整体转名，旧地转名，就是八六厂的老书记嘛，就徐光书记说救不活八幺六，他死不瞑目。然后结合年轻人这个自媒体、融媒体这块发展很快，就是说现在的话，说八幺六景区也是一个小网红哈，抖音呐、大家来了游客以后打卡还是比较多的。从核设施向大众来开放，作为旅游产品也好，科教普及的这种一个基地也好，世界上目前现在只有八幺六。时代发展，和平与发展是一个长期的主题，我们中国向世界表明的一种和平的永志态。